a long fortnight of anticipation, but kickoff of Super Bowl 51 is just about upon us. For these players and coaches, it's the culmination of a lifetime of dreams. Which team will lift the Lombardi Trophy? We're about to find out. It's the Titans going up against the Saints. So the time has come. Let's send you out to the stadium and join the two men that will have the Super Bowl call. Here are Brandon Guyton and Charles Davis.
All right, thanks, Larry. EA Sports coverage of the NFL brings us to the heart of Texas and NRG Stadium in Houston. We count down to kickoff in what should be an epic one here between the Tennessee Titans and the New Orleans Saints. Alongside my good friend Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. We are honored to be here for the biggest spectacle in sports, the Super Bowl. Are you ready, partner?
I am more than ready, and I love the word you used. Honored, because it is an honor to be here. It's a privilege to be here. My excitement is just about to burst through the booth. I can't wait to do this.
Well, and sitting with both of these teams and talking in the meetings and media day and all the hoopla that goes into this, there was one common theme. They're ready to stop the talking and start playing football.
Yeah, they were probably ready a while ago. Now they can just focus on it. It's done. The only talking they have to worry about now is post-game, and they hope that they'll be talking as the winning team.
And we'll see. You know, both sides come in with a game plan to start. We'll see how the adjustments are made throughout, because there are always adjustments in this game.
I want to see if they come out conservative, trying to minimize errors, or if they have enough confidence to attack early and try and take advantage of the other team's nervousness.
Begin the next half century of Super Bowls to a strobe of flashes. Super Bowl 51 from Houston is underway. This one fielded at the 5. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28-yard line. Here come the Saints for their opening drive. And out will come the leader of this offense. And that, of course, is their signal caller. Here on this first play as he gets it to the line of scrimmage and no more. And how about this wide receiving core, Charles?
Well, I was in the hotel watching a little film, and you popped your head in and said, these receivers are pretty good from what I can tell. You're exactly right. Can't wait to see them do their thing out on the field.
Ten yards still left on second down. And now whistles and a flag, and I think we got a jump here.
Neutral zone infraction, defense.
Too quick to the trigger that time. Neutral zone infraction, and that'll cost him 5 yards. Is a gain of 8, and it moves the chains. And boy, they had high praise for this rookie receiver when we asked the coaches about him, didn't they?
They certainly did, and obviously they liked his measurables, otherwise they wouldn't have brought him onto the team. Height, weight, speed, all of that. But how about what they really said? Competitiveness. That's what they really liked about him. The way he goes after the football, competes for it, and decides when it's in the air, it's his and only his.
A look at the defensive starters for Tennessee.
Joe Hayden is a complete cornerback. He tackles, he covers, and does everything with incredible speed.
Here we go with second and seven. Time getting it to about the 46. Just a couple on the pickup there, and now it's third down.
The best defensive linemen, they play with great leverage so they can get low and not get bowled over by offensive linemen. They have excellent hands. They can throw people off on a play. We just saw a great example of a really good run stop by a guy playing the defensive tackle position.
He'll look to throw, and Graham's got it over the middle. 8 yards there on a first down.
When you execute a drag or a crossing route really well and give them a chance to let it develop a little bit, you can gain some significant yardage hitting your tight end on that one.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's going to be hemmed in and brought down right at the line of scrimmage. That's going to go as a loss of a yard, and it'll be second down. And here comes play number six on this drive. Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Throwing right, and that's complete. And he gets this inside the 35-yard line. They'll look to throw now on first down. Wide open receiver complete. A gain of six there on first. And the pocket's been protected pretty good here so far on the opening drive.
We always talk about confidence in runners and catchers and quarterbacks. How about the protection detail? They're not allowing anyone near the guy throwing the football.
He'll look to throw. It's caught outright by Graham. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line. It'll be a gain of four. And that'll bring up what looks to be a third and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
And they'll run it here. And hit behind the line. He lost the football. It's loose. And they are going to set up shop at the 32-yard line. And without a doubt, not the way they pictured that opening drive unfolding.
No, they were making progress. They weren't exactly in high gear, but they were making a few yards along the way. And now that they've coughed it up, you got to go back to the sidelines and regroup a little bit.
They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And Gronkowski's got it, complete over the middle. And he'll be taken down, but not before he gets into enemy territory. And that's one of his advantages of a passer, is it not? With his height, setting back there in the pocket, firing it over the middle, he can really see everything clearly.
It is, and I know that other quarterbacks get it done different ways, all right? You don't have to be his height to make a great play, but what he does is he takes away having to make those slide steps in the pocket to find angles to throw the ball through. He just throws right over the top of it because he can see everything, and sometimes that saves time and gets the ball to a receiver quicker.
So one quarter down here in Super Bowl 51. Can't wait to see what the second quarter has in store. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. With the former Volunteer Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gauden. It's the Titans with a football here to begin quarter number two, and they've got it here with a first down. They're going to look to throw. It's brought in left side by Tate. No gain there on the completion. Second and 10. The defense loves to hang their hat on that, don't they? You get a guy that catches the ball, but you stop him for no gain.
Without a doubt, because they're also used to trying to catch people after the catch, and they miss. And that turns into what? A huge play. We've seen it so many times. In this case, though, catch was made. Put down right on the spot.
Looking for his all-pro tight end, Rob Gronkowski. Third down here. And the offense looking to pick up the first down after the second and incompletion.
Even in today's NFL, when we think of the tight end position now as really a glorified wide receiver, we're still asking a lot of those guys. They have to block as well, and every now and then, they don't come down with the football.
On now is Vinatieri as he'll try the field goal. From the left hash, this will be a 52-yard attempt.
We know it's not an easy job to go out and catch passes when people are trying to tackle you and knock the ball away. But the bottom line is, that's a pass he's got to have and a pass he should have caught.
So no surprise if Vinatieri able to convert there. He is, of course, the owner of the NFL record for most postseason field goals.
Hard to believe he was undrafted coming out of college. And now here he is into his 40s, and he's still one of the best kickers around.
And after the made field goal, here's Adam Vinatieri to kick it away. This is fielded at the goal line. And a pretty good return here. He'll be stopped just shy of the 25 at the 24-yard line. And the Titans defense, they get ready. They take the field again. And we're going to get a peek at some of the hits that have helped them get this first half lead.
And you know how the best hits happen? By being really good on that side of the ball in terms of fundamentals, being in the right spot, diagnosing plays well, and being there at the point of attack. They are really making it happen.
Try the ground game here with the running back. And he is going to lose yardage here. It's a loss of four there, bringing up second down.
The evaluation process in today's NFL does not take into account as much bulk as it does speed. And that's what we're seeing with the linebacker position. Those guys that can run, they can play at any spot because they can make plays on the opposite side of the line of scrimmage.
And he will find his man on the end route, complete. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down. And just a small glimpse there as to why they like this rookie so much.
And that's why they lit up a little bit in our meetings with the coaching staff, didn't
yeah,
they?
When we talked about him, they did.
Yeah, they like his work ethic. You know, this guy's running every route well in the route tree and getting better at it all the time, really honing his game. They expect a pretty good jump out of him as things continue to move on.
Got a man, and he hits him in stride. They get 14 yards there and a first down.
I don't care how many times we see it. I still get a kick out of watching quarterbacks and receivers do the pass tree in pregame warm-up. But I always remember that when we go to practices, we see that after practices as well. They really tune it up, don't they?
They tune it up. They know why they do it for these situations. First down.
And they build that trust, and that's why they're able to find him in this type of a situation. They know that old expression, it's not my night. It hasn't been his so far. I don't know if the legs are a little bit heavy. Sometimes having to hang out all day and play doesn't exactly play to your advantage, but it's been a tough go for him.
Yeah, every time he looks up, somebody's there defensively. That was the same case on that play. Only a gain of a couple there. That leaves him needing about seven here on third down.
Well, I think we know by now that every run is not going to be broken and get all the way to the end zone. But these short ones still have their value. You can still set up your play action and throw the football. You control the clock because you have the ball and they don't. And often the physicality sets the tempo for the game.
And that is incomplete.
But that was pretty nice to watch if you like a defense's perspective, because they understood where the first down line was as much as the offensive guys did. Did not give up any more ground. And when the ball was thrown, reacted really well and swatted it away. One of the advantages of zone defense, you never take your eyes off the quarterback. And when he reacts, you do exactly the same and go get the ball.
Out come the Titans now. And fortunate to get points on the board last time. They had to hit a really long field goal to do so.
The kickers in today's game are so good and so skilled and hit from distances that we almost start to take them for granted. And we can't do that. That's a long field goal that they got 3 points out of. They've got to feel good about that. And they better make sure they love him up because he's helped them out.
Yeah, now we'll see if that offense can put six on the board here. We'll see. Coming up at the intermission, we'll get highlights of this Super Bowl from Larry Ridley and the crew in Orlando with our EA Sports Halftime Report. He's going to leave this for his running back. It's complete. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. Now a timeout being called as there's an injured Titan down on the field. While the training staff works on him, we'll step aside and be right back. So here we go, first and 10 now. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And this is incomplete. Gronkowski, the intended target. And it's second down. So they're still at the original line of scrimmage here. Second down and 10. Gun. They'll look to throw. Caught right side, Tate. And he'll be taken down, but not before getting this inside the 30. Well, we saw the practice film this week. They wanted to focus on these intermediate passing plays, and it paid off there.
And they took that focus not just to the practice field, but in the film room to show the guys exactly what they wanted, what types of looks they should expect to get, and how they would beat those coverages each and every time, and it paid off on that play.
Looking middle, it's caught by Gronkowski. And down inside the 15, shy of the 10. And the next snap coming inside the red zone here. Looking to speed things up here, going with some tempo. On first down, he'll drop to throw. His throw caught right around the 6. A good pickup of 6 there on first down. Now hold everything here. We're going to get a timeout by the offense. So that means they're down to 1 remaining here as we head toward halftime. They'll look to throw again. This is caught, Gronkowski. A 5-yard gain, and now they're set up first and goal.
He's the epitome of what we call the move tight end, a guy that you can line up anywhere, in the slot, out wide, in tight, doesn't really matter. Because he has such great skills, you want to utilize him in all aspects of your passing offense.
And there he was in the slot for the catch. They'll run it now, out of the gun. And they will stop him after a fairly minimal pickup. He'll get 2 out of that run, and it's going to bring up a 2nd and goal. And quickly, they get to the line. Touchdown. Jarvis Landry there to make the grab. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead. And that'll give them a 2-score lead here, but I'm looking ahead. They just want to hold it for the final moments here of the second quarter. They don't want to give up anything on the other side.
No, not at all, because if they don't, it almost had the feel of an imposing their will score. And right now, they want to make sure they keep that and carry it into the second half.
And it's up and good. And here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And he'll get across the 20 before he's brought down at about the 23-yard line. To him right up the gun. And a short gain there as he'll get it up only to about the 24. Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9.
A 1-yard gain can look like a disaster, but it all depends on how the game is going. Is it a series of 1-yard gains running the ball? If that's the case, you might have to start.
And he loses the football a 2nd time. It's picked up by the Titans. So we've reached halftime at a low-scoring 51st Super Bowl from Houston. As we send you over to our headquarters in Orlando, where we check in with Larry Ridley for our EA Sports Halftime Report.
Thanks, Brandon, and welcome to our EA Halftime Report. I'm Larry Ridley. The Saints are behind right now, but the home crowd should give them a boost. The Titans will want to come out after the half really put the pressure on from the start. So here we go. Let's take a look at some of the highlights from the first half. We move late into the second. Hero will get a pass into the end zone, and it's caught for the score, pushing the lead to 10. So that'll do it from here in Orlando. The second half of Super Bowl 51 still to come as we rejoin Brandon and Charles in Houston.
Both teams appear ready for the fight ahead, and we resume action here in quarter number three. This is fielded at the goal line. And he'll get it up to about the 26-yard line, just across the 25. The Titans offense now, they get set to head back out here. And they will simply, Charles, be looking to duplicate what they did last drive when they were able to push it in for six.
And they hope it'll be that easy, right? To be able to take exactly what happened before, replicate it. They may have to make a few additional changes along the way because I'm sure the defense will make some adjustments, but they've got to have great confidence having scored the last time out.
Shotgun snap as they'll look to throw. Throwing for his running back, and he's got him complete. And he'll be brought down right around the 37. It's a 9-yard gain, and it keeps the drive moving.
And a nice gain and a broken tackle along the way. And really, we shouldn't be surprised, should we? That's what runners do, especially the best ones. They break tackles and gain extra yardage.
And on the ground they go with a running back. And a good swarm to the football defensively as they get him down at about the 40. Give him a couple on the carry there, second and 8.
That's a good play by the guys on the defensive side of the ball. Held him to a gain of 2. And that changes the playbook a little bit now for the guy calling plays. Second and 8. Now he's got to probably think about going to the air instead of maybe staying with the ground game.
Oh, the ball comes out on the hit, but they'll say it's incomplete. Golden Tate, his intended receiver. And it's third down. Pretty good coverage there, and both of these defenses, they've had good coverage throughout this one.
No doubt about it, and in today's NFL, where we're used to a bit more scoring, this feels almost like a well-pitched game in baseball on both sides, where the tension continues to build. Who's going to make the big play?
And he's got the first down yardage before he's brought down at the 42. And the play goes for 19 yards, gives him a new set of downs.
They were full-scale, loose, flexible, finding a way to catch the ball in some traffic for a key first down.
Yeah, really a nice job of adjusting to the ball in the air. Not the most accurate of throws, but able to adjust and make the grab. They go play action here on first down. Oh, he's got a man wide open, complete. It's a gain of 21 that time. And it'll give the Titans a first down. Well, clearly one of his advantages as a passer is his height, sit back in the pocket, fired over the middle. That makes things tougher defensively, doesn't it?
It really does, because your goal is to move the quarterback off his initial spot when he gets his drop back completed. But when you have that type of height, he can stay in there if he's willing to take the hits and just fire over the top, which saves him time and actually completes a play a little bit quicker than it normally does for a quarterback who has to slide and find open space to throw.
It's a 3-yard pickup, and that sets up a first and goal.
Okay, no score on that play, but this guy's been a touchdown machine all year long. You know they trust him with the football.
He'll look to throw. This will be caught just inside the 10. And into the end zone for a Tennessee touchdown. Golden Tate from 8 yards out. And the Titans find a way to stretch their lead. As a former DB, you might not like to see that, but from a wide receiver's perspective, those are the plays they dream of.
Correct on both counts, all right? Because once he took off, I mean, let's face it, that should have been done in Big Sky Country. Aren't any speed limits out there? And off he went. Glad I wasn't the one trying to chase him.
Vinatieri now for the point after. He's got it, and it's 17-0. It's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. This fielded a few yards into the end zone. And last year, that would have been a net gain of 5 on the return. This year, he stopped where he would have been if he had taken a knee. And that's at the 25. Our eyes shift now to the Tennessee defense here. Recovered the fumble, up on the scoreboard. They've got the momentum.
And that's a confident group that we see hitting the field again. Just what you talked about. Took away the ball the last possession. They feel like they can go ahead and do it again. They are locked in and feeling good about how this game is going.
And they're playing free. They're playing loose.
Yeah, and that's a good thing. You know, sometimes it can be a bad thing if you're too free, too loose, and you give up your responsibilities. But not this unit. They are ready to go.
See if they stay on the ground for second down.
And that's why you see a lot of teams that like to play 4-3 defense, especially against teams that run the ball really well. Because you count on your defensive front, the tackles and the ends, to eat up the blocking in the offensive line and keep that guy in the middle clean so he can roam through the football and make a tackle. In this case, he introduced himself and said, "Hello, my name is Mike." And that's another stop for the defense, something we've seen all game long. They have been on fire today. No matter what's called by the offense, they've had an answer for it.
They'll set up a throw, and incomplete here on third down. Jimmy Graham, the intended receiver, and fourth down coming up.
Today's NFL, these big guys are featured receivers. They move all over the place to try and find good matchups, and they had one. They were just unable to complete the pass.
Here's Brad Nordman now, as he'll punt it away for the second time. Landry. That'll wind up being a 50-yard punt, though they do get 10 back on the return. And it'll be Titan football. And here comes Tennessee as they get set to take the field. That recipe on their last drive that resulted in a touchdown looked pretty good, so they'll be hoping to do that once more.
And it takes me back to when we sat with the offensive coordinator and the head coach. They felt pretty good about their game plan and felt there were some holes in the defense, and they exploited them the last time out. Let's see if they can come back and put together a similar drive.
And we'll see if they can do just that. It's a loss of a yard there, and now second down.
Well, on that play, the expression, "don't blink, you might miss something," certainly applied. That was fast. Defense diagnosed the play, and it was over in a heartbeat.
One quarter remains in Super Bowl 51. We'll return with more after this. This is the NFL, and it's on EA Sports. Back now here on EA Sports. It's the Titans. They've got the football. They'll be looking to extend their lead here as we begin the fourth quarter. Throw here. Wide open receiver complete. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
And when an offense is doing a nice job selling the play-action pass, a lot of responsibility shifts to the linebackers. They're the ones that have to determine run or pass and get to the proper places on the field.
They'll run it now out of the gun. And he gets it inside the 35 and just shy of the 30. That one goes for 13 yards and it moves the sticks.
Well, I'd say that run's pretty emblematic of what we've seen all day long. No matter what they've done on offense, this offensive line has controlled the line of scrimmage, giving them time to throw it, run it, do whatever they wanted. That's why there are points up on the board. And right now, the psyche of the offense, we're in control and we can do whatever we feel like doing out here on the field.
Whoosh! And down he goes, taking it inside the 10, just shy of the 5 at the 6.
I'm still an old-school football guy, and anytime you see a big-time running play, that fires me up. And if I'm on offense right now, in the position they're in now, inside the 10-yard line, I think after the way they've run it, they've set themselves up for a good play-action pass opportunity right here.
They'll look to throw. His pass caught at the 4. And he'll be brought down here at the 3-yard line. The completion good for 3, and it's second down.
When you see zone defense and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you got to be really careful as a passer about how far you let your guy go, because he might wander into some tough coverage.
Here we
Second and goal as the offense looks to try to punch it in. And he's going to get this back to the 3-yard line and no further. It'll go as no gain on the play, and now they're looking at a third and goal. The fourth quarter here, they've got the lead. They want to keep it on the ground. That's what they're doing.
Smart football. Keep the clock grinding. Keep it going. But you got to figure now, they're going to see more people stacked up at the line of scrimmage as they try and bleed it out.
An encroachment penalty here, maybe just a mental lapse, partner.
Sometimes you have to just watch the football. Make sure it's snapped before you're jumping.
They've gotten it to the one. Can they get that final yard here on third and goal?
There we go now.
And he gets in. Touchdown, Tennessee. A great effort there. Punching it in from a yard away. And the Titans are going to add on to their lead.
Well, they decided to run it in and got it done on third and goal. A lot of times, that's a passing play.
And the kicker, this has to come out for the PAT. He can breathe a sigh of relief as well, right?
Although I don't know if he's really breathing a sigh of relief. I think he likes to put 3 points on his ledger.
Vinatieri now to tack on the PAT. And the lead is now 24. Here's Vinatieri now to kick it away after the touchdown. This will be taken in at the one. And he's up past the 20 to the 22-yard line. Now whistles, and we've got a man down. A man down here following the kickoff. While the training staff takes a peek, we'll take a break. They'll come out in the pistol. They'll come out throwing here on first down. He's got time in the pocket. To the sideline, and oh, a nice catch there. Made sure the feet were inbounds, and they were. Second down now after the pass completion. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And he's just going to get rid of this thing to no one here. He throws it away, and now it's third.
Not too many things get to a quarterback of this magnitude, but I think it's safe to say that pressure can get to any quarterback.
And he's obviously a great franchise quarterback, but felt the pressure, threw it incomplete. On third down, he'll drop to throw. Throwing the slant pattern here, complete.
Personal foul, face mask, defense.
And a big face mask penalty here of 15 yards.
You never want to get your hands up in the face mask area because your fingers can get tangled up there, and that can hurt you as a player.
Again, we'll see the pistol here. Now a play fake here on first down. Looking left sideline, but it's incomplete.
I hope I don't sound too rah-rah on that one, but that's the exact right throw. Either your receiver gets it or no one gets it. Give him a lot of credit for being really precise with it.
Got rid of it. No one got it. And second and 10, he'll look to throw again. And Stills over the middle. 6 yards is the pickup, and that'll lead to a third down.
That was a nicely run slant route, and what the receiver's trying to do is make the defender think he's going upfield for a deeper route and then breaks it off, usually after about 3 to 4 steps, and cuts towards the middle of the field. And now what he's trying to do is use his body to keep the defender away from the football and give the quarterback a really nice target.
2 minutes to go in Super Bowl 51 from Houston. We're back to crown a champion after this. So it's Saints football as we get you reset. And let's see what they've come up with offensively after having time to talk it over. They come up in an empty set. Four wide receivers, one tight end. Back to throw now on first down. And he's got his man on the out route. And he's going to get this inside the 30. It'll go as a gain of 12. And the Saints are going to get a first down. They'll look to throw here. Looking left side, he's got it complete. And taking it to the 15-yard line before he's brought down. And now it looks like they're going to be in the hurry up. From the red zone now, they'll look to throw. And Graham's got it over the middle. 5 yards on the catch there, brings up second down. So they complete the pass, and now they face a second down. They'll stick with the passing game as he looks to throw. And he just chucked that one out of bounds, out of everyone's reach. Maybe a wise call not to take a sack in this part of the field. It brings up third down. They got pressure there and only rushing three.
And there's a defensive coordinator right now who is celebrating not just getting home with three there, but realizing if that's the type of pressure he can get in the entire game, then his pass defense is going to be excellent. You're dropping eight. Where are you going to go with the football?
Back to throw again. His pass caught at the four. And he will have the first down before he's brought down at the three. And this seemingly endless drive continues. Again, he'll drop to throw. And he's got him. It's caught in the end zone. Touchdown, New Orleans. Kenny Stills, a 2-yard touchdown grab. And the Saints make some inroads here to that deficit. On those slants, everything happens so quickly. What makes it work?
The timing between the passer and the receiver. In this case, a slant route. Ordinarily, it's probably about 3 steps before you go on the slant. In this amount of time, I think it's a 2-step deal. Boom, put his foot in the ground and got inside for the pass.
Got inside for the pass, got inside for the catch and the score. Well, it's still an uphill battle from here, that's for sure, but that makes it a 2-score game.
And now we see why teams practice so much on the 2-point conversion, why you have more than one play ready, because you may need multiples throughout a ball game. There's a great example right there.
They knew they needed a miracle. They had to have that onside kick. They didn't get it.
Well, as we knew, even before they put the toe to the leather on that one, their chances of getting that done, slim and none. And I do believe we saw Slim just leave the door, didn't we?
We did indeed. I think we're down to none. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he'll get inside. And the Saints signal for another timeout. That'll be their second, so one more chance to stop the clock here. And we'll be back. Come up now in the Wildcat package. Finding his way down to about the 35-yard line. And play is stopped here. Timeout. It's the defense calling the timeout here. That'll be their third and final stoppage here as we step aside. So the defense had a chance to catch their breath, and now they're back out and ready. Third down now following the run. They slot Gronkowski out right. They'll run it now out of the gun. And he's able to get the first here as he's taken down at the 25. A nice pickup there, 10 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
Doesn't matter who the runner is going to be each week. Defenses get ready to gang tackle. They want multiple people to the ball. They want to make sure they take the proper angles to the runner. Make sure there's no place for them to spin out and go what they call through the back door and get away from people. And they want plenty of guys there to hit him, try to knock the ball free, the whole deal. But on that play, the best laid plans did not work.
And they're singing in the Music City. The Tennessee Titans are your Super Bowl champions. And they're remarkable. remarkable season ends in the most remarkable of ways. They get to put next to their name Super Bowl champion.
And they can't ever take that away, can they?
Nope.
That lasts forever. So good to see the emotion when it's all said and done. You see the hugs, you see the guys sharing, the collective happiness. Makes me want to carry you around a little bit on my shoulders to celebrate the triumph. And congratulations to them, a fantastic season.
And they are the Super Bowl champs. The Lombardi Trophy is theirs, and so are bragging rights for an entire season. And what a season it has been. Feels like we have been there every step of the way. Our entire crew doing a wonderful job. Thanks to my broadcast partner, Charles Davis. For all those guys, I'm Brandon Gaudin signing off. We'll talk to you next season right here on EA Sports.